family affair for Italian-Australian comedian Joe Avati. Avati's parents, grandparents, and brother joined him to greet fans in Woodbridge today.
This is my sister, which is Joe's mum.
Hello.
Resemblance? Only she's got hair and I haven't.
Comedian Joe Avati launches his new DVD live in Canada. The Italian from Australia brought along most of his family, and for good reason.
Welcome back to Tribute TV. I'm sitting with international comedian Joe Avati, producer, executive producer, writer, comedian, actor, and food scientist. This guy's got more titles than Muhammad Ali. Joe, great to have you on board, my friend. How are you?
I'm good, Tony, and you?
I'm well, thank you, Joe.
That's good.
Tell us, Joe, what have you been up to?
Matt, I've been in the middle right now of writing a new show called Comicus Erectus, which will launch this year, and launching a new website and just getting into a few other things. I'm really, you know, into food, and so I'm launching a food blog as well.
Fantastic, yeah, Joe. I've seen some of the names on your new show, Joe. George Kapanyaris, of course.
Yes.
Tahir. Yeah. And Basile from the States.
Yeah, Basile from the States. Basil and I first met at the Montreal Comedy Festival when I was producing a show with him there, and he was doing his own show. And he's very popular with the Greeks. And so I thought, and we've been wanting to work together for years and years and years, and now's the time, so I'm really excited to be working with him. And it's good to bring out an international act in the mix.
Well, it's great that you've got a new show for 2012. I know that a lot of people have been asking you about that, Joe.
Yeah.
Can we just touch on, you touched briefly a moment ago on the food interest that you have.
Yeah.
Can you let the audience know a little bit about your background?
I'm actually a food scientist, Tony, believe it or not. And it's got nothing to do with comedy. There's nothing funny about it. It's extremely serious. It's basically, it's an honours degree. So it's majoring in science, so physics, chemistry, microbiology, engineering. But specifically looking at food and how to put food together. I'm not a chef. I love cooking now, but I'm not a chef. But that's basically it. You know.
I had the pleasure of working with you, as you will recall, in 2009.
Yeah, it was a great
with
tour.
Frank Letito as well.
Yeah.
We did the Viva Lost Wages tour.
Yeah.
We toured all over Australia. And it was great to be on board with the comic of your stature. Can you tell us a little bit about why you picked Frank and myself for that show?
Frank's a great act, and he's, you know, he talks a lot about being Italian and so on, and I think that with yourself, you came in at a good price.
Yeah, I'm still waiting to get paid.
But it just fit well. I think it was just fit because I wanted to do something that was more cabaret. I wanted to do something that involved a little bit of singing, a little bit of that Rat Pack feel. And, you know, and you fit right in there. I mean, and, you know, interestingly enough, you guys were the much better singers than I was, you know.
Joe. Don't play it down. You're fantastic.
Yeah,
Joe.
Right.
You're a fantastic singer. A lot of women lining up for your vocals.
Yes.
That's what we'll call it on air.
That's right. I wanted to be a rock star, Tony. I wanted to be a pop star.
Didn't we all?
You know, I wanted to be George Michael. I wanted to be Simon Le Bon from Duran Duran. You know, but you know that it was never going to happen. You know, I'd never had piano lessons, guitar. I didn't know, so I just abandoned it and did science. And then I used to be able to tell jokes at parties. And a friend of mine said, "Why don't you get up at the Comedy Store in Sydney and give it a go?" So I did, and I got laughs. And it just went from there. And I thought, here is my avenue to fame now. And so I pursued it. And that was in 1995. And at that time, I was in my honours year. So I was doing it concurrently.
So you're balancing your study and the comedy at the same time.
Exactly,
so
you're right.
Really at a fork in the road, I'd imagine. There.
Right, exactly right. You know, one was very scientific, one was extremely creative. And then the comedy, within about 2 years, just took off, so much so that, you know, I was earning in a night what I would earn in a whole year.
Joe Avati!
Joe, you mentioned that you wanted to be a rock star. Can you tell me, I mean, I know you were born in the 70s, so you would have grown up with some fantastic acts that we represent on this show.
Yeah.
Can you tell us, who were your favourite acts back then, or bands?
Well, I loved... it was really weird because I was... Even though I was born in 1974, so But, you know, by the time that I started to really grasp music, I was about 10 years old. So now we're looking at 1984.
Right.
Instead of loving the whole 80s thing, I loved the Beatles. That they really inspired me. And it was because of the Beatles, I saw this documentary and I couldn't understand as a child why there was four guys on stage and 50,000 people going crazy. And I wanted to be one of those guys. I wanted to be one of those people that made the people on this side of the microphone go crazy. And so I pursued it. And I was in love with the Beatles as a 10-year-old, which was really strange because everyone else was loving Prince and Duran Duran and George Michael, which I do love as well. I love them. And also Kiss. I love Kiss, you know. Gene Simmons, yeah. I love the music. I love his marketing style. He used to be Italian, Gene Simmons. Yeah, but he changed his name because his name was Gino Simone.
I'll take your word for it, Joe. It's interesting that you mentioned Kiss because you're going to love this next act, Joe. These guys are called Kiss Destroyer. They've been around for years. You won't believe your eyes. Let's roll the tape. This week's trivia question, folks, is what do Gene Simmons from Kiss and Richie Sambora from Bon Jovi have in common? Stay tuned after the break to find out the answer.